Like many professors, I require students to submit all formal written work in my classes as Word documents for a reason. Other file types frequently do not render as readable documents in Blackboard. And often, even if I'm willing to manually download the file, I'm exposing my computer to viruses, or I'm still unable to read the file in any of the word processing programs I have. If you have Pages or OpenOffice or Microsoft Works or some other program, you may sometimes be able to export your files as Word documents. But a more reliable way to get what you need is to use the OneDrive that's attached to your school email. I'm going to show you how to access and work in OneDrive. Please note that if you've recently bought a PC or a laptop, you may have a version of OneDrive that's not connected to your school email. It works pretty much the same, but you may have trouble finding your files from a school computer until you log into your home email. So keep that in mind. So here we are on the Gateway homepage. You need to get to your school email, which is right here. Go to your email. And then it's going to ask you for a login and password. This is the same one as your Blackboard login and password. So I'm logging in. I won't save it now. And here I am in my school email. Now from here, what you want to do is look for this grid of boxes. You may also have it pinned like I do, but go to this grid of boxes here. These are the apps. Click on it and you see you have all the different programs that are available to you. We've got Word Online too, but I'm going to take it to actual OneDrive. So click on the cloud icon for OneDrive and it'll take you in here. Now once you're in here, you can create a new file by clicking on the word new right here. And you see you have the option to create several different kinds of things. What I want you to do is do it as a Word document. So we come in here and now we're in Word Online. Now, as long as we're here, we might as well create a paper in MLA style. So let's format. We're going to start with the font, which is Times New Roman or similar. I would take Arial. It's a little bit bigger and easier for me to read. It needs to be 12 points. So we'll hit that first. And then you set your double spacing over here under paragraph. You can do it here or now. They've actually got it where you can click this tray and open everything. If you see that the spacing after is something other than zero, I would move it back down and make it zero so it doesn't create so many extra spaces between your paragraphs. Your line spacing is going to be double, and there you go. So let's see what's next. The MLA header. So the MLA header is going to be your name as a student. I'm going to make mine Joe Cool, and your professor's name, which you should capitalize and spell correctly. And then next, the class name, we'll say it's ENG101. And then the date. For the date, you need to spell it out. Slash marks are just lazy. If you want to be super MLA compliant, here we are today on February 26th, you can put the date first and then the month. And then 2016 is when I'm doing this. I would take it with February 26th, 2016 too. Whatever makes you happy there, but at least spell it out. Now the fifth line down is for the title, which needs to be centered, and you can do that by clicking on this. Your title needs to be reflective of something in the document. Be creative with this a little bit. Make somebody want to read it, basically. Maybe this is your, my, right, this isn't actually very creative at all, but process. All right. So that's my title for this particular essay. It shouldn't be just the assignment title or essay number one. And then the sixth line down needs to be brought back over to the left margin, which you do like this, align the text left. So now on the sixth line down, it starts your actual paper. You're going to want to hit tab to indent and then just start typing. In my case, I've got something copied here that I'm just going to paste in. And there we go. So that's kind of what it looks like. Realize that your text wraps automatically when you hit the end of a line, so you don't need to hit enter like on an old-fashioned typewriter. And don't skip lines between the paragraphs. Just tab to indent a new paragraph and keep going. Now finally, you want to add a page number and your last name to the top right. In Word Online, you do that by clicking View, and then Header and Footer, and then you want to insert a page number, and you choose top right, and now you see it pops it in there for you. You're going to add your last name capitalized and a space right in front of it, and now that's in there. Now, when you click out of the header in Word Online, this is going to seem to disappear, but don't worry, it's still there, and I'll be able to see it when you upload your file to Blackboard. If you open your file later in a full version of Word, like the ones on our school machines, it'll show up in a light gray, and it's a little bit different way how you get it in there. But basically, just to get out of that, you just click out of that, and then you see it's gone, but it's still there. Now, the last thing you want to do is give your file a name that differentiates it from other files that might be saved in OneDrive. So I recommend that you do this by, you come up here to the top of the file, see it says it's document name, and you're gonna rename it. So you click on it, and I would suggest that you do your last name, I'm gonna say I'm Joe Cool, and a dash, and the assignment title or the assignment name, maybe it's SA1. You can put a version number here if you want to differentiate between different versions of the document, and then we'll say that your class number is 12345. You do that, you hit enter, and now it's saved as that file. Now the main reason to do this is if you want to upload your file in the assignment space later, it's easy to make a mistake if all your files are named something like document 1, document 2, and so on. So let me go over to OneDrive itself now. I'm going to go back here to OneDrive and show you what I mean by this. That file is saved, and that's the great thing about this. If you work in OneDrive, as you're making changes, your file is being saved, so you don't have to lose it later. Now you can see I've got a lot of file folders in my OneDrive, and I also have a lot of documents. See, document 1, document 2, and so on. But this is easy to find because it's the one that I just named. And suppose I want to make changes to it. What I can do here is click on it, and it will open again. And it looks like your file's there, but you can't actually do anything to it till you click Edit Document, and then you edit in Word Online, and now it opens that space that you were just in, and you can make any changes that you want. I'm going to go back here now, though, because it's time to think about trying to... All right, it's time to go back and think about how we're going to get this file into Blackboard, because you can't do it directly from here. So when I'm ready to submit, I'm going to download it to my computer, and I do that by, if I've already got it selected here, I can download from here, and it'll even show me where it's going to go. It looks like it's going to my documents folder. Often it goes to the downloads folder. It's another place you can check if you're having trouble finding it later. So you just click save, and now it's on your computer somewhere. Now from here, you can attach your file to the assignment much the same way you would attach a file to an email. So you just navigate to it and browse and select it, and you're done. Now that you've got this demo, I fully expect to see only Word documents attached to assignments, and I expect to see them properly formatted. Please ask if you have any questions about this, or drop by your campus library or tutoring center for some extra help. Thanks for watching.